The answer is no. It repeats values too infrequently. This may seem a little surprising. If it was random, well, the probability of two consecutive values being equal should be 2 to the negative 128. A very low probability, but not zero. If this is an encryption cipher, well, it satisfies the property of invertibility. So any value that's different here encrypts to a different value. So that would mean that for our actual pseudorandom number generator, this probability is actually equal to zero. And that's different from what it would be in a real random sequence. This probability is low enough that we still wouldn't expect a repetition for a long time, but we would expect to have one within the first 2 to the 70 outputs. And we'll talk soon about the birthday paradox to see why we would expect one this soon. Still a pretty big number, but it would be enough to distinguish this from pure randomness. So to fix that, there's a couple things we could do. One is to occasionally change the key. And after some number of outputs, we can take one output. Instead of using it as an output, we use it as the new key. So even if we don't have any more randomness, we'll still change the key. That will affect this probability. It will no longer be zero. We'll start seeing values that have some probability of repeating what we saw with the previous key. So we'll get a new key every few million outputs. The other concern is whether this pool of randomness is good enough. On Unix machines, there is a pool of randomness stored in devrandom, and it's collecting events that are believed to be random and out of the control of the attacker. These could be user actions like key presses. These could be things that you collect over the network. There's some risk that these could be compromised, that some of them could be controlled or at least predictable to the attacker. So we want to have multiple pools of randomness and combine them in a way that makes it very difficult for an attacker to control this seed. And this is essentially what the Fortuna pseudo-random number generator does, and that's one of the more popular, widely used ones. It does use this rekeying to avoid this apparently non-random property, and it uses multiple pools of randomness selected in a way that makes it very hard for an attacker to control what the seed is, even if the attacker can control one or a few of the pools of randomness.